Hey guys, here I want to show you the how to build a monowheel bike. So here are the parts. Do you need? You need a saddle. Level is not important. Fuel tank, gas engine. Higher level would be good. Fuel efficiency. Four controllers. In that case, a level 5 controller would be good too. Because of the speed, you need 4 sensors, 11 large suspensions, some of the small pipes, T-shape, corner and straights, the diamond steel block, that is this one here, you can craft that in the craft bot. And some wood blocks. I use in my case level 3 wood. It's stronger. So first we need to make the wheel. That is, I think, the hardest part, to get the symmetry right on all sides. So we need first 5. Then we need 3, 1 diamond steel, 2 again diamond steel, 1 diamond steel, 2 diamond steel, not this, diamond steel, and 3 and 5, like so. Place on the 5s here and here. Again, the blocks. Please don't fill that and the gaps, because if the vehicle is parking, not moving, only 2 blocks will touch the ground. Lesser collision, lesser frame bugs, etc. You know the problem currently. So, here, 3, 1. 2, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, and 5. And repeating the same pattern around the wheel. 3, 2, 1, 1. 2, 1, 3, and 5. Okay, here and here. Hopefully, I didn't make a mistake. That would be the first time. 2, 1. And oh my god, first time try. I did that 4 times. Every time I did a mistake. So now we can make the cross in the middle and remove basically the middle of the middle. 3 and 3. So, and place 4 large suspensions, so they meet in the middle and place 1 block. So make sure it is on the lift, that's important, otherwise it will only connect to 1 suspension. And that will be not good, it needs to be on all 4. So then we can remove the lift, place just a temporary block on it. Use the weld tool, weld against that, remove that block, so we have it like so. Then we need to make the propulsion suspension glitches. That's here a corner pipe, here, here, and here. The same on this side. So I will make it only on side and explaining and the other side I will do fast without talking. So here we need T-pipes. Here. Same as here. Here. Then we need some straights here to close the gaps. So now we can remove this part, not this block. It needs to be stay there because of the for the suspension, and the same here, from T-pipe to T-pipe. So then place bearings against the T-pipe ends on all sides. Then we need T-pipes on the inside pointing out. So make sure it's first only here, then here, the order is important, then the suspensions against them, and then the end T-pipes. Don't make them before you place this. So, then the T-pipe here, and this must be green, this and this. So, it's connected to all three. The same here. All green. And finish. So, then take a block, place it here and here. One. Whoops. One bearing here and here. So that is the wheel part. Now we make the frame, and here for this side, the seats. So go here and drag one block up. One, two. The same here. And then down to here. That is two blocks to the ground. Or, sorry, three blocks. Like so. The same on this side. To here. The same height. And then go here. One block free and drag that over here. So goes through the suspension, use the weld tool and connect the two sides. If the wheel is spinning, the middle part here can go through all suspensions without colliding. So then we can take the fuel tank here, we place that straight in the middle. So use two blocks, place it one here, oh sorry, not here, one here and one here. Then take the engine, place it against the bar here, make it one go down, so like so, remove the lift, take the saddle and place it so it's in the middle. Then we take the sensors, but first put it again on the lift. Take the sensors, place one here, pointing down. The same here in the middle of the seat at the end, like so. Take the controllers, place them how you want. I make it so and so, and then I use this two for forward and backward tilting, and this two for left and right tilting. So for that we can connect them direct to the corresponding controllers. So the front sensor from here, do I connect to the front controller, or the back for this one, from the left sensor to this one, and from the right sensor to this one. Easily. So now we need the suspension glitches for tilting left, right, forward, backward. So the vehicle is straight up all time. For that we need a bearing here at the top. That free space, and again a bearing. Same on the other side. One at the top. 1, 2, 3, and here. And again the same we can do here. I would say make it at the bottom. That free space, and so. Then take the corner pipes again. Place here. Here, here, and here, like so. Then take the large suspension against the corner pipes. Here and here. Then again, corner pipes. Make sure it stands on the lift. Booth must be green. Here and here. Here and here. Then we can attach the steering mechanism. So basically a suspension glitch. Make it here and here. A corner pipe. Suspension. And here. For that, just connect the bearings straight to the seat. So, then you can connect the fuel tank to the engine and direct the engine to the seat. So, then the bearings here from the wheel, not the middle shaft, the bearings must be not connected. Don't connect them to anything. The shaft from the wheel, don't connect them. They must be free. So the suspension glitch bearings from the wheel to the engine. Just connect all. I think on each suspension glitch you don't need to connect all. I think only this, but I'm not sure right now. So just connect all. You can test it later if you want. So then, if you stand on the left side of the vehicle, the seat pointing forward, look against the bearings and they must turn anti-clockwise. So this one is wrong, this one is wrong, this one is wrong, this one. It must spin obviously in this direction. So if you put some fuel in the tank, we can test exactly this. We can test now turning left, right, and drive forward and backward. Currently, nothing holds it up, so don't wonder if it falls over while the testing. So, left works, right works, perfect. Oh, we need more engine power. Don't put it on max, that will not work. Because of the suspension glitches, they will spin here around, but not the wheel. So, I think this or this is the maximum, but then it's not needed. So, see, that is working. It's not spinning fast, but it has a really high torque. So, now we can first set the controllers. for that, we go here to the first controller. We did say that is for if this sensor is hitting the ground, then this should spin the vehicle in this direction. Also the frame of the seat must spin this way. So we have connected the sensor to this controller, and this we connect to the suspension glitch on this side only, the front, and then only the number one here at the second, at the first state, not the default state, must be 15 and on fast. That is basically the setting for all the same, for all controllers is the same. It must be look like this. But you can change that if you add more more weight, some things on it, that you must play with the values here. Sometimes it's enough, sometimes not. So keep that in mind if you buy this and change a bit. So the same should we do here with this side, but to the back spinning controller. Again, not the drive shaft bearings. Make sure you connect not them, only the suspension glitch bearings. So again, first on 15, second not, and fast. If you connect the bearings to the controller, make sure you begin from the main bearing, so from the, how can I say that, from the attachment side of the suspension. If you place the suspension this side, so this from this bearing, that must be the first in the controller, then the top one. In this case, it is this is the first, that is the second, on the other side the same, here and here. So the same do we here. Oh, here are this side is the first, as that is the second, and the same is here. So now we go to the left and right controllers. The left one to the left suspension glitch. First the down and then the up one. Same here and here. We go in. First on 15, speed on fast. 15, speed on fast. So now we can set the sensors, the forward and backward on 3, and the left and right on 2. So 1 and 2. And here they are one higher, so 3. Now we can test and set the bearing directions, and for that we must release the vehicle and it can spin crazy around. Just for testing, so if you want to test it, you can place for leaning left and right, you can place a block under one sensor and it should spin this way. And that's not so, we have both sides on the same direction, then we can change one. It's the lift. Remove the block, remove the lift. Again, place a block underneath. Not so, not so, and so. It should lean left, but not too far. If you remove the block, it should spin back. Perfect. So now we check that is wrong. So the first controller, you see the highlight connections, it is connected to here, so we can change the direction here. I did mess up. It is correct. So, like so. I think I have switched the directions. Yes, that must be this way. Yes, you see, you must play a bit with the values and then it should work. Every time how in which direction you connect the sides, and that is always different. So only check the sides, yeah. And that should work, okay. And now if I didn't miss something, it must be done. So, and it looks like it's correct. Yep. So, I hope you like it. It's a simple creation. How I did say, it's very strong. Oh, maybe I'm lucky and I can fly over the rock here. And yes, it works. See? It's a good off-road vehicle. And it should always set it straight. Yes. So, that is this vehicle, and you can attach some things on it. But, whoops. I did, for example, here a little minigun or potato gun test, and it works really good. Shoot. If you break, it shoots a bit down. If you go back, it shoots a bit up. Also can shoot very precise and aim. So it's funny. I hope you like it, then please give me a like, and we see you soon with new ideas.